Hi, my name is Joni Partonen and I'm a product engineer in Vaisala. In this video, I will show how to upgrade Indigo 500 transmitter software. And this software is freely available in our website. And there might come a day that you want to upgrade your own transmitter with the latest software and get the benefits of the latest features. For the update, you will need standard RG45 Ethernet cable and size 4mm hex key. And then you will also need a laptop PC where you have downloaded the software from vaisala.com. So let's get started. Now, depending on the configuration, you might have Ethernet cable already connected and you have this device connected to your facility Ethernet network. But in this case, I don't have Ethernet connection, so I need to create the Ethernet link between my PC and this transmitter. And let's see how to make that. You will find the Ethernet port here. So let's connect cable there. And one more thing, if this is the first time you will use the web user interface, you need to make the activation, and that's where you need this activation code that you can find from here. Now we need to build a LAN network between my PC and this transmitter. And now that it's point-to-point connection, it's the easiest configuration is that both of these devices have a static IP address. And let's set this Indigo 520 in static IP address first. And we go to transmitter and network, static IP, and then you're free to choose whatever IP address you want to use, but typically a LAN network has IP address of 192.168, and let's say that this is 1 and 2, like that. And then we need to define the subnet mask as well. And a gateway. And for the gateway, I will set 192.168.1.1, and this is the IP that I'm going to use in my laptop. So you need to have a different IP address for the transmitter and for the laptop. And now apply. And you can confirm that the IP address is correct. If you take a look at the menu, you'll have to wait for a while. And it should show up. Yeah. Okay, same thing for the PC. And typically your PC is configured for DHCP, but this time we will use static IP. And you need to find this network connections, and here the Ethernet, and properties, and we will configure this IPv4 and use a static IP. .192.168.1.1, and subnet mask is 255.255.255.0. Okay, now we should have the connection. Let's try it out. First of all, this web user interface works in HTTPS protocol, so that's what we have to type here. And then the IP address of the device, and it was 192, 168, 1 and 2. And then we need to define this port that the web user interface uses, and it's 8443. Now you get a message that the connection is not private, and this is because of the certificates. And you have to go to the advanced and proceed. And if this is a first time when you use web user interface, you need to make this user creation. And this is where we need to use the activation code that I mentioned before. It's in here. So let's type that here. And the activation code was OK. Then I need to define a username. Let's put admin here, and then a password. Length must be 12 characters. And there's also optional guest account, but this time we will not create this one. And now it's time to reload this page. There is a countdown timer, so it takes a couple of minutes before you should reload this page. Okay, if it doesn't reload automatically, you can try to reload it a couple of times, and eventually you will get this login prompt. And now it's time to use our defined username and password. Now we have connected into a web user interface. And through this user interface, you can make all the configurations and adjustments, export data and so on. But this time we will use this web user interface for a software update. It can be found from here. Now we need to locate the file that we downloaded from vaisala.com. I have it here in my downloads folder, and the first thing to do is to extract this file. And here we have the firmware binary that we need to choose from this, and here it is. And, now it's time to upload. This will take a while to get it uploaded and validated. Depending on the software that you had on this device, you may need to press this activate button to actually activate the latest software that is now installed in this device. Now it's time to boot the instrument. Therefore, we have this network error, and this web user interface naturally doesn't work during this boot process. And again, it takes some time to load up the web user interface server, so be patient and try to reload the page maybe in a few minutes. Great! Software is updated and we have new features, actually this specific version. Changed these analog output settings. So it's always a good idea to check all the settings after a software update, that you have the right type of range and correct probe settings in place. Now when the software update is completed, It's time to remove the Ethernet cable and close the lid.